Его Божественная Милость Ачхе Бхактивиданта Свами Прабхупада, основатель и духовный учитель Международного общества сознания Кришны. История начинается с пророчества. Пророчество, которое сделал аватар Господа Кришны, известный как Шри Чайтанья Махапрабху, или Золотая Аватара Кали-Юги. 500 лет тому назад он предсказал, что в каждой деревне и в каждом городе будет воспеваться Харе Кришна Мхамантра. В 1922 году молодой Абхай Чаран, который позже будет известен как Шрила Прабхупада, встретил в первый раз Шрилу Бхакти Сиддханту Сарасвати, выдающегося религиозного ученого и духовного учителя, который поручил ему начать проповедовать послание Шри Чайтани по всему миру. 11 лет спустя, в 1933 году, он получил инициацию от Шрилы Бхакти Сиддханты и официально стал его учеником. А в 1959-м принял отреченный образ жизни или саньясу и таким образом стал Бхактивидантой Свами. После долгих лет усилий и подготовки, в возрасте 69 лет по указанию его духовного учителя, 13 августа 1965 года в порту Калькутты Шрила Прабхупада сел на корабль Джаладутта, направляющийся в Америку, для того, чтобы исполнить пророческие слова Шри Чайтани Махапрабху. Через 35 дней, 17 сентября в 5:30, он прибыл в Бостон на пирс Commonwealth. На следующий день корабль отправился к Нью-Йорку, конечному пункту назначения Шрилы Прабхупады. Остальное уже история. Меньше чем через год Шрила Прабхупада уже появлялся на национальном телевидении, и о нем пестрели заголовки газет по всему миру. CBS presents this program in color.
I'm Reed Collins. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. A hypnotic rhythmic chant of 16 words has replaced LSD and other drugs for some in New York's East Village. On 2nd Avenue and 1st Street is a storefront in which a Hindu Swami has set up shop. There, his American disciples are learning about Krishna consciousness.
This man led a worldwide revolution in consciousness in the 60s. Wherever he went, thousands of people were there to greet and honor him. His name was A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, and he brought the Hare Krishna religion to American shores.
Nothing's gonna change my world. Nothing's gonna change my world.
He even influenced the Beatles, and they helped spark interest in Krishna.
This world is gliding above the ocean, my sweet Lord.
And explore the life and character of the man who influenced the lives of millions and made Hare Krishna a household word.
In the main Hare Krishna mantra, it's the word that's not Hare or Krishna.
I have lost my sense of direction.
Have you tried Hare Krishna?
I'm
honored to be with you today for your commencement from one of the finest universities in the world. And I would walk the 7 miles across town every Sunday night to get one good meal a week at the Hare Krishna temple. I loved it.
At different times, Swami Prabhupada was known as a scholar, a philosopher, a cultural ambassador, a prolific author, a religious leader, a spiritual teacher, a social critic, and a holy man. He was not one of those modern entrepreneurial gurus who come to the West with slickly packaged, watered-down versions of Eastern spirituality. Swami Prabhupada was, rather, a true holy man, a person who was called Acharya, which means a master who teaches by his own example. Swami Prabhupada formed the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. This later developed into a worldwide spiritual community with hundreds of centers, schools, temples, and farms, with thousands of dedicated disciples. To have achieved all this in only 12 years was a remarkable achievement. But in addition, Swami Prabhupada also wrote and published over 80 volumes of translation and commentary on the great classics of ancient India. His books were welcomed with great critical acclaim by the academic community, and they were soon accepted in many universities and libraries around the world.
Dr. Stilson Judah is professor emeritus at the University of California at Berkeley. His field is the history of religion. We asked Dr. Judah to tell us about his association with Swami Prabhupada.
The International Society for Krishna Consciousness is a bona fide movement. It is a movement which is actually older than that of Christianity. The worship of Krishna is one which is extremely popular in India. It is one of the great religions of India at the present time, as it has been throughout all of the years of history.
Sometime in the spring of 1967, people handed me clippings from New York newspapers saying that there was a Swami in New York City. So I went to New York to look up this person and his movement. My first contact was with disciples apart from Bhaktivedanta Swami, and as soon as I met him, which was after several visits to the temple, I realized that this was the person who really made the whole thing go. But the impressive thing about that was he was never himself in the center. He never said, "You should do this because of me." He always said, "You should do this, and I should do this because of Krishna." When he gave them instructions to do what they thought were impossible things, like he told one of the early disciples, "Go start a magazine." A guy had never had any contact with a magazine before in his life except to read one. And he said, "How am I to do that?" And Bhaktivedanta Swami said, "Krishna will help you." He was just astonishing in terms of the personal impact that he had on people, the way that he was able to give them confidence in themselves, but more importantly, give them confidence that there was a guide who was leading them and would give them the strength that they needed.
Between 1966 and 1977, Swami Prabhupada circled the globe 11 times. Whenever he traveled, he would emerge daily into the chill and quiet of the early morning, and he would take a lengthy stroll with an entourage of students, disciples, and guests.
Bhaktivedanta Swami does not belong to New York. He belongs to Krishna. So when a few of his followers invite him to San Francisco, he goes and introduces the freewheeling youth to Krishna, his ancient culture, his spiritual food, his eternal chant, the way to stay high forever. In the heart of the hippie movement, Haight-Ashbury, Golden Gate Park, and in the hearts of the hippies, the Hare Krishna mantra resounds with unimagined potency. As in New York, Bhaktivedanta Swami gathers sincere followers. The Hare Krishna movement begins to grow. Bhaktivedanta Swami becomes respectfully known as Prabhupada, meaning one at whose feet the masters sit.
From the Broadcast Center for Northern California, this is News Center 4.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You founded the Hare Krishna movement some 7 years ago in 1967, did you not?
Yes.
In a capsule, what is the movement?
The movement is to awaken God consciousness of the human being. The human being is distinguished from the animals, that the animals cannot understand what is God. And if the human being also does not understand what is God, then he's animal.
I see. And so your movement is to bring about an understanding of God among human beings.
Yes.
And Hare Krishna means what?
Hare Krishna means addressing the energy of God. Hare means the energy of God, and Krishna means God.
Okay, you were here yesterday and to attend your annual festival that was held here in Golden Gate Park, and we were there too. And in fact, here it is. A few thousand people came out to hear it. How many people are now disciples of the Krishna consciousness movement?
Dedicated life, about 10,000.
About 10,000 dedicated
in
ones.
In the Western world.
You say that Hare Krishna consciousness pretty much takes the absolute truths from the Bible, the Quran, the Torah, and the Vedic.
Yeah, everywhere.
Everywhere.
Religion means to understand God.
I understand, but do you feel that in getting truths from various places like the Bible and the Quran and so forth, don't you run into conflicts at all or contradictions in those particular philosophies?
No, I don't find any conflict, because the ultimate goal is God. So you have to understand God and try to love Him. So you can go through any religious process. If the goal is attained, that you understand what is God, and you try to love Him, then your life is perfect.
Why do we see so many of your followers chanting almost all the time?
Chanting means to keep association with God always.
So you have to audibly chant Hare Krishna?
Yes. This is transcendental vibration. Just like a radio message, if you keep contact with the radio message, then you know everything, what is going on outside. Similarly, this transcendental sound, Hare Krishna, if you chant, then you keep connection with God directly.
Thank you very much, Your Divine Grace. It's been our privilege to talk with you and to meet you.
Thank you.
And hope that we can see you again when you return.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah. We'll be back with more news in just a moment.
How do you explain their growth so quickly? I mean, what is it? We're only talking 33 years here, right?
23 years. And that's a very good question. I think it has a lot to say with what people look for in a religion. Krishna consciousness is very authoritarian. It is very rigorous. When they say no stimulants, they mean coffee. They mean no coffee, no tea. The founder came at exactly the right time, Larry. He came in 1965 when American culture was in turmoil. People were looking for new answers, for new ways to explore. So along came a man who had a different way. It was very, Prabhupada was, his power was really spiritual, and he laid out a new path for people to follow.
Wow.
So the religion became a bridge between East and West.
Шрила Прабхупада получил высокое признание от множества западных ученых из лучших университетов по всему миру. Этими книгами нужно дорожить. Тот, кто читает эти книги с открытым сердцем, не сможет остаться равнодушным, независимо от своей веры или философских убеждений. Доктор Гарри Гиллейд, профессор психологии, Оксфордский университет, Англия. Высоконаучное, авторитетное издание Бхагавад-гиты, осуществленное Ачи Бхактивиданта Свами Прабхупадой, произвело на меня глубокое впечатление. Этот труд представляет огромную ценность как для ученого, так и для рядового читателя. Его с равным успехом можно использовать и как справочное издание, и как учебник. Я настоятельно рекомендую это издание моим студентам. Это замечательная книга. Доктор Сэмюэл Эткинс, профессор санскрита, Принстонский университет США. Я поражен, как учение одного человека, исследование им своей духовной традиции, могло так сильно повлиять на жизнь множества людей. На мой взгляд, вклад Шилы Прабхупады является очень важным и будет очень долговечным. В возрасте, который мы называем преклонным, когда большинство людей почивают на лаврах, он взялся исполнить наказ своего духовного учителя и отправился в трудное и опасное плавание к берегам Америки. Безусловно, Шрила Прабхупада – это один из многих тысяч духовных учителей, но вместе с тем он – единственный из тысяч, а может быть и миллиона. Харви Кокс, профессор богословия Гарвардского университета. Позднее доктор Кокс подкорректировал свою фразу. Когда я сказал, что Прабхупада был один из миллиона, я думаю, что недооценил его. Пожалуй, он был один из сотен миллионов. Вклад в современную культуру, включающая прямую ссылку на движение Прабхупады.
Они верят в Кришну.
Кришна? Кто такой?
Кришна – это Бог.
And so we're going to put him in the Hall of Fame. We're going to induct him. We're going to just push him right in there. But I need you all to say Hare Krishna.
Have you heard of Krishna consciousness?
How'd you like a Hare Krishna?
Shark still looks fake.
Hi, friends. Goldie Wilson III for Wilson Hover Conversion System.
Even everybody needs support. Like this one time, I left the supermarket in a really bad mood. And then I met these very nice people, the Hare Krishnas.
Little soul, armed with only a gold badge and those stripes of gold paint down his nose, he was Krishna Cop.
That's why Hare Krishna, as I was saying, the Hare Krishnas are tough.
Let's see it. I got it.
Hare Krishna.
Шрила Прабхупада собственноручно сделал популярным собственное движение во всем мире, как это было предсказано Шри Чайтанья Махапрабху. Его божественная милость Ачья Бхактивиданта Свами Прабхупада, основатель и ачарья Международного общества сознания Кришны, настоящий праведник с безупречным характером и святыми качествами, также известный как Уттама Адхикари, преданный высшего порядка, осознавшая себя душа и Парамахамса. Его наследство всегда будет жить в его книгах, его наставлениях и в его искренних последователях.